You've seen the newsreels of walls of flame, smoke-filled skies, and evacuated communities. But what you don't see is the process behind the scenes that informs land managers how to prepare before wildfires start. Fire danger is the term used to describe this bigger picture, longer-term look at the wildfire potential of an area. You probably have experience with fire danger as well. It just might not be as flashy as those scenes of wildfire. Fire danger's most obvious visual is a sign with smoky bear and a color code rating indicating the fire danger. There's a lot of science that goes into determining these fire danger ratings, and there are a lot of ways that this information is used for planning, preparation, and wildfire prevention. So what is fire danger? It's a value that shows the potential of a fire becoming large or difficult to suppress. The fire danger changes throughout the year as conditions change. When fire danger values are very high and extreme, you know that the area is experiencing conditions that may lead to an increase in fire activity. Fire danger is calculated from current and forecasted environmental conditions, like how hot, dry, and windy it is. The hotter, drier, and windier the conditions are, the more likely the vegetation is to burn. You could probably imagine that if the fire danger is high, it's a good idea to limit the likelihood of human-caused fires and position resources so that if a fire does start, it's more likely to be controlled. How do we limit the possibility that people will start fires? Limitations can be placed on when and where campfires are allowed, or other potential fire-causing activities such as fireworks, target shooting, or debris burning. There may be recommendations or restrictions for people that operate machinery outdoors to limit certain activities during peak fire danger conditions or require certain wildfire prevention and firefighting equipment on hand. Remember, the reason these rules come into play is that, based on past experience, the current environmental conditions have the potential to lead to large or hard-to-suppress wildfires that may have lasting impacts. Fire managers may move fire prevention resources, firefighters, and equipment across the country based on multiple factors, including fire danger. The positioning of resources in an area is a strategy that allows firefighters to respond faster to fires in areas where they might grow quickly and there are resources that need protection. If an area has a potential for large or hard-to-control wildfires, getting resources there early would help reduce the likelihood that those resources are impacted. Fire danger can also be used by fire managers to help inform decisions related to prescribed fire in order to achieve planned objectives. To help demonstrate the purpose of fire danger, let's think about what it would look like if we did not have fire danger as a tool. There would be fewer adjustments to the activities of the public when conditions were hot, dry, and windy, and there would likely be more human-caused ignitions that grew into large fires. There may not be additional staffing in areas with high fire danger, so crews would have to come in from farther away, giving fires more time to grow. During these periods of high fire danger, wildfire prevention efforts become more important. Moral of the story, fire danger is an important tool to help the public and fire managers make decisions that will result in fewer negative and more positive impacts from wildland fire.